something that could resemble a yoga strap. And let me pin myself. Spotlight. Okay, we'll do a quick sound check and you let me know if it needs to be someone can unmute themselves or you can say higher, lower, or good. What do we think? Is it good volume? Does it need to be higher or lower? It's also like the beginning of the song. Let me just short. Good. Higher. Good. Okay. Great. Okie dokie. Let's start in a child's pose today. You can have your strap or whatever you're using as a strap close by. You can bring your big toes to touch and your knees wide, your arms extended. You can also come into more of a traditional child's pose, legs together, arms down by your side, whatever feels comfortable. And take a moment to tune into your body. Notice where you are in this moment without judgment. No need to change or shift your body. Just notice how you feel. And take a moment to notice your breath. Notice your ujjayi breath, your inhale and exhale through your nose. And allow this ujjayi breath to help guide you through your practice today. And start to bring any gentle movement into your body if you want to sway your hips from side to side or shake your head no. Maybe wiggle one finger, like one hand a little higher than the other. Take one more inhale and then exhale tabletop position. Bring your hands right underneath your shoulders, knees underneath your hips. Inhale cow pose, pause here. Slide your shoulders down your back, pull your chest forward and pull your tailbone up towards the ceiling. One more inhale. Exhale cat pose, curve and round, pause here. Push your hands into the ground, try to pull your spine up towards the ceiling. Really let your head relax. Good, and pause here. See if you can squeeze out a little bit more flexion, pushing more into your mat. And we're gonna move one vertebrae at a time. So keep looking at your belly button. Start to tip your tailbone up towards the ceiling and start to sway your spine, slowly moving one vertebrae at a time. Slowly into your cow pose. Pull your chest forward, slide your shoulders down your back, and then slowly you lift your head to take your gaze forward. Good, hold here, take an inhale. And then exhale, keep looking forward, tuck your tailbone under, try and isolate one vertebrae at a time as you slowly move through into your cat pose. Push your hands into the ground as you slowly let your head drop down. And then I'm gonna let you do two more on your own. So we just did one all together, moving from cat to cow, and then cow to cat would be one. Take your time and notice if one part of your spine feels a little tighter or more challenging to articulate. And you can notice without judgment, just knowing like, oh, my upper spine feels a little tighter than my lower spine, or it's harder for me to mobilize my thoracic spine or maybe in between your shoulder blades. And just spend a little bit more time when you get to that segment of your spine and see if you can slow down and again move one vertebrae at a time. So it sometimes is a little challenging to focus on moving one vertebrae at a time, but hopefully this movement feels like a nice massage for your spine. Good. And then when you're done with your second one, pausing in cat pose, and then you can take a few breaths on your own if you want to take some circles in your spine or flip your palms around. Maybe circle your shoulders, whatever feels comfortable for you. Just get some gentle movement to help wake up your spine a little bit more. Good. And then come into a neutral tabletop position, letting the tops of your feet relax. Push your hands into your mat and squeeze your belly button in. We're going to take some circles in our shoulders. So pull your shoulders up towards your ears. Roll your shoulders together like you're pinching a pencil behind you. Slide your shoulders down your back, and then push your hands into your mat to roll your shoulders back towards your ears. Pinch your shoulders together, slide your shoulders down your back, and roll your shoulders forward once more. Lift up, pinch, slide your shoulders down, and roll forward. Now we're going to reverse. Slow, roll your shoulders down your back. Pinch your shoulders together, roll forward, push your hands into the ground, slide your shoulders down, pinch, lift up, and one more time, slide down, pinch, roll forward, and release to center. Good. Take a couple more breaths. Again, any movement that feels comfortable. Maybe you want to let your head relax, flip your palms around, move through another set of cat-cow, whatever feels comfortable. Good. And then neutral tabletop position. Bring your right hand behind your head. Push your left hand into the ground. Make sure your hips stay square over your mat. Over your knees the whole time. Push your left hand down and twist your right elbow up towards the ceiling, twisting in your ribs. Make sure you're not shifting your weight closer to the right side. Inhale. Exhale, twist your right elbow down towards your left wrist. Inhale, open up to the side, push into your left hand. Exhale, twist your right elbow down towards your left wrist. Inhale, open up. And twist. Once more, open up, pause here. Extend your arm straight towards the ceiling, your right arm. Make a fist with your right hand. Press your shoulders down your back, especially your right shoulder. And then we did this last week, internally rotate your arm in, and then externally rotate. Internally rotate, and externally rotate. So if you stuck your thumb out, your thumb would point, as you internally rotate, your thumb would point behind you, and then externally rotate, your knuckles would turn towards your face and your thumb would point behind you. Again, internally rotate, and externally rotate. And come to center. Inhale, release your fist. Exhale, thread the needle. Bring your right arm underneath your left. Pause here. Good. And then you can keep your left hand on the ground if you want to extend your left arm up or place your left hand on your low back. Whatever feels comfortable for you. Good. Take two more breaths here. One more inhale. And then exhale, slowly unwind. Pause in your tabletop position. Notice how one side feels different than the other. And then push into your right hand. Bring your left hand behind your head. Keep your hips right over your knees as you inhale your left elbow up. Twist to the side. And then exhale your left elbow down to your right wrist. Inhale, open to the side, push your right hand down. Exhale, twist your left elbow to your right wrist. Inhale, open. Keep your hips square. Exhale, twist. Once more, inhale, hold it here. Hold the twist open, and then extend your left arm up towards the ceiling. Make a fist, and then again, go through some internal and external rotation. And so when you're moving here, you want to move your arm within your shoulder socket. So try not to roll your shoulder down and back. Slide your shoulders down your back and move your arm bone within your shoulder socket. Good. If it helped you before, if you want to stick your thumb out and watch the rotation of your thumb, just careful the rotation isn't coming from your wrist, it's coming from the top of your arm. One more internal rotation, one more external rotation. Back to center, release your fist, take a breath. Exhale, thread the needle, bring your left arm underneath your right. And again, you can stay there if you want to take whatever variation you did on the first side, do again on this side. Good. A few more breaths here. Think of almost like you're gonna roll in a like sideways somersault behind you. Really try and roll your weight back behind you. Yeah, so you really get that nice twist in your ribs. Good. One more inhale. And then exhale, slowly unwind back into your tabletop position. You're gonna slowly step your right foot out and then your left foot out into your plank position. Spread your fingers nice and wide. And now the same shoulder circles we did in a tabletop position, we're gonna do in a plank position. If it feels challenging, it's kind of like a pat the head, rub the belly exercise, then pop your knees back down. Lift your shoulders up towards your ears. Pinch your shoulders together. Slide your shoulders down your back. Push the floor away to roll your shoulders up towards your ears. Pinch, slide down, and roll forward, up, pinch, down, and forward, reverse. Slide your shoulders down your back. Pinch your shoulders together. Roll your shoulders forward. Slide your shoulders down your back. Pinch your shoulders together. Roll your shoulders forward one more time. Slide your shoulders down your back. Pinch your shoulders together. Roll forward back into your neutral plank position. Inhale, exhale, downward facing dog. So hopefully you felt that in your plank position, it was a lot more challenging to feel the stability as you move through your shoulders. And you may have felt that your elbows bent or your head was moving with you. Keep in mind the next time we do that, you want to only move your shoulder blades. And take a few breaths here in your downward facing dog. If you want to bend your knees one at a time or let your head relax, you can. And then inhale, bend both knees, take your gaze forward. Slowly travel your weight to the top of your mat. Walk your feet forward into your forward fold. Pause here. Pour your weight into your toes, let your head relax. You can hold onto your elbows. You can interlace your fingers and let your arms stretch overhead for a chest expansion. Good. See if you can pour your weight a little bit more into your toes rather than your heels. Good. I feel like I did a sound check at a very low song. Can you all still hear me okay? Okay, good, just making sure, because it's super loud in my ear, so I'm either yelling at you or you can't hear me, I'm not sure. One more inhale. And then exhale, release your arms, bend your knees, look at your belly button, and slowly roll up. Relax your arms, stack your hips right over your heels as you roll all the way up. Inhale, mountain pose, reach your arms high. Exhale, Samasthitihi, bring your hands to heart center. Pause here. Close your eyes if that feels comfortable. Feel your feet anchored into your mat. Feel the crown of your head floating up. Feel the warmth between your palms. And take a moment to set an intention for your practice. If nothing comes to mind, I offer you the intention just to have fun. Enjoy that you've made it to your mat. Enjoy moving through the postures. enjoy your practice, maybe with a smile on your face or just an inner smile. And we'll seal our intention with a breath. Inhale through your nose. Exhale through your mouth. Slowly flutter your eyes open. Inhale, mountain pose, reach both arms high. Exhale, baby back bend. Squeeze your glutes, pull your chest up towards the ceiling as your elbows come back behind you. So instead of pressing your hips forward and reaching your head back behind you, think of pulling your chest up towards the ceiling, and that makes the back bend. Inhale, mountain pose. Exhale, forward fold. Lift your tailbone, push your weight towards your toes as you let your head relax. Inhale, halfway lift, find length in your spine. Exhale, low lunge, step your left foot back. Inhale, crescent moon, drop your knee down, but keep your toes tucked. Reach your arms up towards the ceiling, pause here. Pull your right hip back and push your left hip forward so your hips are square. Make sure you're not dumping forward and putting pressure into your low back. Try to scoop your tailbone under as you guide your hips forward. Good. And take one more inhale. Exhale, baby back bend. Pull your chest up towards the ceiling as your elbows reach to the side. Stay lifted in your lower abdominals and keep trying to tuck your pelvis. Good. One more inhale. And then exhale, plank pose. Press your hands down, step your right foot back to meet your left. Slide your shoulders down your back. Inhale, pull your heart forward. Exhale, slowly lower your stomach all the way onto your mat. Untuck your toes. Inhale, cobra pose. Pull your chest forward. If you're pregnant, if you want to stay in tabletop position and come into cow pose, you can. Slide your shoulders down your back. Scoop your tailbone under. Pause here for two more breaths. Good. Yogis who are in cobra pose, lift your palms off of your mat and see if you can let your back do a little bit more work. Yogis who are in tabletop position, really use your back muscles to push your shoulders down your back. See if you can squeeze out a little bit more extension. Keep your palms off of your mat. See if you can lift your chest off of your mat a little bit more. Hold for one more inhale. So we should all feel our back muscles really, really engaged here. And then exhale, downward facing dog. Place your hands down, tuck your toes, lift your hips up and back. Inhale, shift your weight to your right foot. Exhale, low lunge, step your left foot forward. Inhale, crescent moon. Keep your toes tucked, drop your knee down, reach your arms up, pause and take a few breaths. Keep your tailbone scooped under, push your left hip back. And the reason why I want you to keep your toes tucked today is so you can push down into your toes, so you can keep some engagement in your hips. One more inhale. And then exhale, baby back bend. Pull your heart up towards the ceiling. Remember, try not to lean your head back. Lift up first, and then you can open up your heart. One more inhale. And then exhale, forward fold. Launch off your right foot and step forward to the top of your mat. Let your head relax. Inhale, halfway lift to reset your spine. Pull the top of your head away from your tailbone. Exhale, fold. Inhale, bend your knees. Look at your belly button. Slowly roll up. Really exaggerate the tuck of your tailbone as you scoop your hips under your spine and roll all the way up. Inhale, mountain pose. Exhale, baby back bend. Squeeze your glutes. Lift your lower abdominals up towards your ribs. Inhale, mountain pose. Exhale, forward fold. Soften your knees as you fold over. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, low lunge, step your right foot back, left foot stays forward. Inhale, crescent moon, drop your knee down, reach your arms high. Exhale, baby back bend, pull your heart up, keep your lower abdominals engaged. Exhale, plank pose, press your hands down, step your left foot back. Anchor your shoulders down your back, inhale, pull your heart forward. Exhale, slowly lower your stomach all the way down, untuck your toes. Inhale, cobra pose, pull your chest forward, pause here and breathe. And again, yogis who are in cobra pose, pop your palms off of your mat and hold it here. Keep your feet relaxed. Sometimes we'll lift our toes off of the ground or we'll push our toes in. See if you can just let your back do the work. Good, now keep your spine where it is. Place your hands down. Push your hands into the ground. Try and pull your chest farther forward, like you're trying to slide yourself forward.
Good. And then again, pop your hands off of the ground and hold for four. Make sure you're breathing. Three, two, and one, downward facing dog. Inhale, shift your weight towards your left foot. Exhale, low lunge, step your right foot forward. Inhale, crescent moon, reach your knee down, reach your arms high. Exhale, baby back bend. Inhale, pause. Exhale, forward fold. Step to the top of your mat, let your head relax. Pause here for two breaths if you want to hold on to the outsides of your elbows. Maybe you want to pause and shake your head yes or no. Good. Inhale, halfway lift, find length in your spine. Exhale, fold. Heel toe your toes to touch and leave just a sliver of space between your heels. Inhale, chair pose. Sink your hips down, reach your arms high. Pause here. Scoop your tailbone under. Not so much that you're rounding your low back, but just enough so that you're not sticking your tailbone out behind you. Anchor your shoulders down your back and reach your thumbs back behind you. Squeeze your inner thighs together as you sink weight into your heels. Inhale, bring your hands to heart center. Exhale, prayer twist to your right. So pull your left elbow to your right, just about 50%. So 100% would be touching your elbow to your knee. See if you can lean forward and twist just about 50%. So you're really using your obliques. Make sure your hips and knees are still pointing forward. Inhale, center. Exhale, prayer twist to your left. Again, just 50%. Careful, sometimes our knees and hips will turn with us. Just your ribs and your core does the work. Inhale. And then exhale, unwind straight into your forward fold. Let your head relax. You can heel toe your feet underneath your hips. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, plank pose. Press your hands down and step your feet back. Inhale, shift your shoulders forward. Slight change here. Exhale, chaturanga. Optional knees or not as you lower your chest down. Inhale, upward facing dog, pause here. Pinch your shoulders together, lift your knees and thighs off of your mat and pull your heart forward. Think of finding length in your spine here. Oftentimes in upward facing dog, we think about pulling our head back and opening our throat. Instead, see if you can find length in your spine. One more inhale, exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, lift your right leg high. Keep your hips square. Try not to open to the side. Exhale, right knee to right elbow. Pull your shoulders over your wrists. Squeeze your heel towards your butt. Inhale, lift your right leg high. Exhale, knee to nose. Curve and round. Try and kiss your knee. Inhale, take your gaze forward. Exhale, low lunge. Step your right foot through. Good. Inhale, warrior one. Spin your left foot down. Extend your arms up towards the ceiling. Keep your shoulders, ribs, and hips continuously pushing forward. So sometimes we like to open up to the side here. If you find that's happening, you have two options. You can shorten your stance a little bit, or you can widen your stance a little bit and keep twisting. So if you want to kind of wiggle your toes the width of your mat, that might help you a little bit. It's a challenging posture, so if you're not fully twisting straight forward, don't worry about it. Just know that over time, our bodies will adjust. One more inhale. Exhale, warrior two. Adjust your feet if you need to. Hips press forward as you extend your arms forward and back, taking your gaze over your front fingers. See if you can deepen the bend in your front knee just a little bit more. Inhale, reverse triangle. Push into your front leg. Push your hips forward as you reach your arm back behind you. Good. Soften your tailbone down behind you. Just a gentle touch of your left hand onto your left leg. Good. And then you're gonna bend your right arm. So your right fingers are just gonna touch the top of your shoulder blade. And you're gonna take some circles leading with your elbow. So let's take some circles clockwise. And then we'll do clockwise or counterclockwise. So just as if you had a crayon on your elbow and then reverse, you're making a big circle. Loosen up your shoulder joint.
One more inhale. And then exhale. You're going to extend your arm, hold for one more inhale. Exhale, triangle pose. Pull your hips towards the back as you reach your arms forward and down. If you have a yoga block, you're welcome to hold on to your yoga block. If you don't have a yoga block, you can either gently touch your fingertips to your leg, or you can turn your palm to face out so the back of your hand pushes against your leg. Make sure that your hips press forward, that your hips aren't sticking out behind you. You want to pretend like you're in a narrow hallway. Good. Nice, yogis, good. One more inhale. And then exhale, low lunge. Cartwheel your hands down, turn all 10 toes forward. Press your left hand down, pause for your inhale. Exhale, low lunge twist. Reach your right arm up towards the ceiling. Pause here. Really push into your left hand. It's easy to kind of sink down. Imagine you could stretch your fingers so close to the ceiling that your left palm would actually float off of the ground. It's not actually gonna happen, but try and find that nice openness in your left shoulder joint. Good. Hold for one more inhale. And then exhale, plank pose. Your choice, move through your flow or straight to downward facing dog. Nice, good yogis. Good. Inhale, lift your left leg high. Exhale, left knee to left elbow. Pull your shoulders forward. Use your obliques to pull your knee in. Inhale, left leg high. Exhale, knee to nose. Try and kiss your knee around your spine. Pause here. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, low lunge. Step your left foot forward. Inhale, warrior one. Push your right foot down as you reach your fingers high. And again, if you need to shorten your stance or widen your stance, you can. That's your choice. Guide your left hip back and stay lifted in your lower abdominals. That same feeling you felt in your low lunge twist in your shoulder as you were lifting up, see if you can find that feeling in your hip joints. Instead of sinking down and pushing down, push into your feet, but lift in your abdominals to lift some weight out of your hip joint. One more inhale. Exhale, warrior two. Make any adjustments with your feet if you need. See if you can send your left knee a little farther forward. Push into your right pinky toe and take your gaze over your front fingers. Release any tension in your jaw. Inhale, reverse triangle. Push into your front leg. Lift up and back behind you. Just a gentle touch of your right hand on your right leg. Finding a lift in your lower abdominals, that same thing, trying to lift up out of your hips. And then bend your left arm, placing your fingers on your shoulder, and then take some circles clockwise, and then we'll reverse going counterclockwise. Still stay lifted, just getting some lubrication to your shoulder joint, and then reverse the direction. And then inhale, left arm high. Exhale, triangle pose. Pull your hips to the back, tick-tock your arms to 12 and 6. And again, your choice. If you have a yoga block, you can tense your fingertips or place your hand on your yoga block. Try not to lean too far forward just to touch the ground. Stay lifted if you need to. Just make sure your hips are continuously pressing forward. Sometimes if we lean too far forward, our butt will push back behind us, and then we're losing the integrity of the posture. Good. One more inhale. And then exhale, low lunge twist. Cartwheel your hands down. Your right arm goes down and your left arm goes high. Right away, keep lifting your left fingers up towards the ceiling, trying to float out of your right shoulder joint. Good. Find that juicy spaciousness as you extend your arms away from one another. One more inhale. And then exhale, plank pose, and your choice, move through your flow or straight to downward facing dog. Downward facing dog is where we meet. Pause here and take a few breaths. If you want to pedal through your feet, if you want to putter through your lips, if you want to bring a smile to your face. Good. Inhale, bend both knees, gaze forward. Exhale, forward fold. We're going to flow through that one breath to one movement. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Heel toe your toes to touch. Inhale, chair pose. Sink your hips down. Lift your lower abdominals. Exhale, prayer twist to your right. Now about 75%. See if you can twist just a little bit more. Inhale, center. Exhale, twist to your left. Again, 75%. Keep your knees and hips pointing forward. Inhale, center. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Yogi's choice. Exhale, walk, step, or hop back into your chaturanga. Nice. Inhale, upward facing dog. And exhale, downward facing dog. Beautiful. Inhale, float your right leg high. Exhale, knee to nose, and then right away step forward. Good. Inhale, warrior one. Spin your left foot down, extend your arms high. Exhale, warrior two. Adjust your feet if you need to. Inhale, reverse triangle. Keep your arm pointing straight towards the ceiling. Exhale, triangle pose. Pull your heart forward. Good. Pause for your inhale in triangle pose, reaching your fingers down to your mat. And then exhale, low lunge twist. Cartwheel your left hand down, right arm high. One more inhale. And then exhale, your choice, move through your flow or straight to downward facing dog. Good, yogis, good choices. Inhale, lift your left leg high. Exhale, left knee to left elbow, left knee just steps all the way straight through. Sorry, right into your low lunge. Inhale, warrior one, spin your right foot down, reach your fingertips up. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, reverse triangle, push into both legs. Exhale, triangle pose, pull your heart forward. One more inhale, stay lifted in your hips. And then exhale, low lunge twist, bring your right hand down and your left arm high. One more inhale. And then exhale, your choice, move through your flow or straight to downward facing dog. Good. Inhale, bend both knees, gaze forward. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Grab your strap and then bend your knees and roll all the way up to standing. Good. Place your strap over your right shoulder. I'm going to turn around and then reach your arms out towards the side. So we're going into half cow face, which I know we know how to get into, but take these steps with me. Slide your shoulders down your back. Externally rotate your left arm. So you're rotating your left arm internally rotate your left palm. So your left arm is facing back. And then you're gonna keep your shoulder internally rotated as you bend and reach up. Now pause here. Notice if your shoulder is dumping forward. Keep rolling your shoulder down your back. And now externally rotate your right arm. So your right palm is facing up. Push your right shoulder down as you reach your fingers up towards the ceiling and then bend at your elbow. Grab a hold of your strap. Even if you can grab your fingers here, just pause here and hold your strap. Keep pressing your shoulders down your back. Now pull, I don't know which angle to face. Pull your elbows back behind you. So sometimes they kind of want to hang forward here. Push your shoulders back and your elbows back. Make sure your ribs don't come with you. Zip your ribs together, pause here and breathe. And then if you want to, start to wiggle your fingers a little closer. And then maybe if you can hold on, you can. But you should feel enough tension here if you're doing this correctly. You're pressing your shoulders down. You're keeping your ribs tight. You're pulling your elbows back.
Hold for two more breaths. One more inhale. And then exhale, unwind your arms. Just relax your arms down by your side. Pause for a second. If you need to give a little shaky shake, you can. All right, strap over the left shoulder. Reach your arms out towards the side. Internally rotate your right arm. Make sure your shoulder isn't coming with you. Press your shoulder down and then reach up towards your strap. Externally rotate your left arm. Reach your fingers up and then bend at your elbow. Grab a hold of your strap. And then maybe you can wiggle your fingers just a little closer towards one another. And again, pause here. Push your shoulders down your back. Zip your ribs together and pull your elbows back behind you. Good. And then again, if you want to wiggle your fingers, maybe you can grab a hold. Just make sure you're not compensating by arching or rounding. Good, few more breaths here. Notice where you feel the tension. Is it in your upper shoulder or your tricep? Is it in your lower shoulder, your rotator cuff? One more inhale. And then exhale, release your arms and release your strap to the side. Shake your arms out. Bring your toes to touch. Leave a sliver of space between your heels. Inhale, chair pose. Reach your hips back, arms high. Exhale, hands to heart center and full 100% twist to your right. You can bring your elbow on the outside of your knee. Pause here. Good. And if you feel like the 100% twist isn't where you are today, then twist as much as you want. Hold for one more inhale. And then exhale up and over to the other side. Elbow on the outside of your knee. Make sure hips and knees still point forward, that we're not twisting in any way. Good. A few more breaths here. Good, inhale, bring your hands to heart center, unwind. Exhale, yogi's choice, walk, step, or jump back into your chaturanga. And then you can finish your flow. Inhale as you go up, and then exhale as you go back to downward facing dog. Beautiful yogis. Inhale, float your right leg high. Exhale, low lunge, pull your knee towards your chest, step through into your low lunge. Inhale, warrior one, spin your left foot down, extend your arms high, pause here. Inhale, your fingers behind you and puff up your chest. Exhale, humble warrior, bow forward as you reach your arms overhead. Now make sure that your shoulder and in your chest is not resting on your right leg. Push your right hip back behind you and reach your shoulders and your chest to the inside of your right leg. And now careful not to overcorrect that you're turning your chest to the inside of your legs, still chest pointing forward. Good, one more inhale. And then exhale, warrior two, unwind your arms. Inhale, reverse triangle, push into both legs, pause here. Option to come into your half cow face. I'll turn around to face the back. So you can grab a hold here. Maybe grab your strap or maybe even just hold on to your shirt. Inhale, exhale, keep your bind, triangle pose. Pull your hips to the back, pull your chest forward. So maybe you don't go as low this time, or maybe you want to ditch your bind and come into traditional triangle pose. That's your choice. One more inhale, and then exhale, unwind into your low lunge twist. Cartwheel your left hand down, reach your right arm high. Drop your left knee down and release the top of your left foot. And then reach your right arm back behind you. So you're extending your fingers back towards the end of your mat. Keep lifting up out of your left arm and hold it here. Good. One more inhale. And then exhale, your choice, move through your flow or straight to downward facing dog. Inhale, lift your left leg high. Exhale, low lunge. Pull your knee towards your chest and step through. Inhale, warrior one. Spin your right foot down. Extend your arms high. Exhale your fingers behind you. Puff up your chest. Take one more inhale. Exhale, humble warrior. Bow forward to the inside of your left leg. Let your head relax. And remember, keep your hips square. Try not to overcorrect and pull your chest to the inside of your legs. Pull your left hip back. Keep your chest to the inside of your left leg. Good. See if you can bring some softness into your shoulders and just let gravity do the work to reach your arms overhead. Good. One more inhale. Exhale, warrior two. Unwind your arms. Inhale, reverse triangle. Pause here. Option, if you did before, to come into your half cow face. Inhale. Exhale, triangle pose. Option to keep your arms where they are or unwind your arms. Make sure your right shoulder doesn't fall down. Keep twisting, falling over, and keep the integrity of your triangle pose. One more inhale. And then exhale, cartwheel your hands down into your low lunge. Drop your right knee down and release the top of your foot. Exhale, twist your left arm back behind you. Keep lifting out of your right shoulder. Lift in your lower abdominals. Twist to look back towards your left fingers. One more inhale. And then exhale, your choice, move through your flow or straight to downward facing dog. Good. Take two more breaths here in your downward facing dog. And then inhale, plank pose. Pause here. Spread your fingers nice and wide. Push your hands into the ground. Abs stay nice and tight. Inhale your right knee to your right elbow. Squeeze your heel towards your butt. Pause here. Hold for your inhale. Exhale, twist your right elbow to your left knee. Inhale, right elbow to right knee. Exhale, right knee to left elbow. So you're twisting. Right, left, right, left. For four, three, two, and one, plank pose. Inhale. Exhale, left elbow to left knee. Pause here. Squeeze your heel towards your butt. Inhale. Exhale, twist to your right. Twist to your left. Twist to your right, twist your left, pick up the tempo. Right, left, for four, three, two, and one, downward facing dog. Pause here. You can pedal through your feet, you can shake your head no. If you wanna rest in child's pose, you can. Good. And then shift your weight towards your left foot. Step your right foot on the outside of your right hand. Drop your left knee down and release the top of your foot. We're gonna come into a quad stretch. So if you wanna reach your right arm behind you and you know you're good to grab your foot, you can. You also have a strap if you wanna place your strap around your foot and grab your strap as well. Make sure when you grab your foot that you're not either sinking into the left side or rounding your spine to grab your foot. Think of scooping your tailbone under and keeping your lower abdominals engaged so you're not dumping pressure into your low back. If you don't want to grab your foot, you also have the option to place your hand on your knee and just enjoy this twist. Maybe squeeze your heel towards your butt, maybe not. Few more breaths here. If there's any other variations you want to take, you're welcome to. And one more inhale. And then exhale, slowly unwind. You're gonna keep your feet where they are, your legs where they are, and you're gonna walk your hands to your right leg. Interlace your fingers behind you. Inhale, puff up your chest and reach your knuckles back towards your heel. So it's not reaching your knuckles to the ground.
you're reaching your knuckles back towards your heel to create a nice open spine. Good. Pause for one more inhale. And then exhale, slowly release. Push back into your downward facing dog. Inhale, shift your weight to your right foot. Exhale, step your left foot on the outside of your left hand. Drop your right knee down. Inhale, release the top of your foot. Exhale, wrap your left arm around to grab your right foot. You can also just place your hand on your knee and enjoy that twist. It's up to you. Remember, if you're taking your foot, whether you have the strap or not, make sure your butt doesn't reach back behind you and you're not rolling onto your right side. Stay lifted out of your right shoulder. Think of tucking your tailbone under, almost like you're gonna do a cat spine. A few more breaths here. Enjoy this quad stretch. This can be a pretty intense stretch for some, so if you're feeling your breath start to tighten or shorten, remember your intention to enjoy your practice. Maybe your Ujjayi breath will help you release your hips a little. Maybe you lift the sides of your mouth up towards your ear. Hopefully you're smiling. One more inhale. And then exhale, slowly release your right foot and bring your hands up to your left thigh. Interlace your fingers behind you. See if you can go the opposite grip than what you did before. Inhale, puff up your chest and pull your knuckles back towards your right heel. So again, not down to your knee. Pull your arms back behind you. Pull your chest up. Keep your abdominals engaged. Two more breaths here. One more inhale. And then exhale, your choice, downward facing dog or child's pose. Good. And then you can make your way into your child's pose. Good. Take two breaths here in your child's pose. Good. Slowly walk your hands in to have a seat on your heels. Okay. We're going to go into full cow face. So before we did half cow face, now we're going into full cow face. If you know that the half cow face, you need your strap, you can grab your strap. You can sit your hips onto the ground. I'm going to face forward, or sideways technically, but you can face whichever direction you want. So there's three different options for your legs, and I'm just going to very quickly say. Option one is cross-legged position. Option two is double pigeon or fire log, where you're stacking your legs. Option three is what we would do for full cow face, to stack your knees. So notice how my feet are nice and wide. My hips can both stay on the ground and my knees are stacked. And then you would go into the cow face. So let's just get our legs associated first, in, or into position first. So again, your choice, cross-legged, half cow face. Oh, let's bring our right leg on top. I should clarify that. So right leg goes on top, or you stack your knees. And take a minute to make sure your hips are nice and anchored down wherever you are. And then tee out your arms. You're going to externally rotate your right arm. Sorry, I'm not mirroring you. And then internally rotate your left. Reach your left arm down, your right arm up, and then bend your elbows. And then your choice, you can grab a hold of your hands, you can grab a hold of your strap or your shirt. And again, if it feels like too much, maybe you want to stay in half cow face and just do your legs, or maybe you want to sit in cross-legged and just do half cow face for your upper body. Nice. Good, yogis. Good. And remember what I mentioned when we were doing just half cow face with your upper body. So I'm going to turn to the side. Careful if you're leaning forward a little bit.
try and pull your elbows back behind you. And the same thing, if you feel like your ribs are sticking out, try and zip your ribs together. Imagine you're up against a wall so your back is nice and flat. Good, let's go for one more inhale. Take your time, exhale, slowly unwind your arms, and you can sit back and straighten out your legs. Maybe give your legs a little shake or rotation. And then, second side. So your left leg will come on top, either in cross-legged, fire log, or double pigeon, or your half-cow face. And I definitely have to wiggle into it, so if you have to wiggle into it as well, that's totally fine. And then tee out your arms. Internally rotate your right arm, externally rotate your left arm, and then you're gonna reach up and back, grab a hold so your left elbow is up, left leg is on top. And you can use your strap. I know that for me, my left side is tighter, so I know that I need my strap for the left side. No harm in using props. And again, go through your spine. Make sure you're not arching or rounding. Sometimes we kind of jet our chin forward. See if you can pull your chin back. Imagine you're pressed up against a wall. It's a pretty intense stretch, so do what you need. Make modifications and remember to focus on your ujjayi breath. Release tension in your jaw. Two more breaths. One more inhale. And exhale, slowly release. Straighten your legs. Give your legs a little shake. All right. If you have a block, we're going to go into bridge, wheel, and then legs up the wall. So if you have a block and you want to use your block for legs up the wall, or if you're close to a wall that you want to just right now scoot your mat up against the wall, you can. You could also use like a couch or a bed if you have it close by. And then when you're ready, you'll make your way on to your back. I'm gonna come up so I can watch. Okay, yes, get yourself situated. Perfect. Okay, so we're gonna do bridge pose first. So, sorry, lay on your back, knees are bent, feet are flat, and then you're gonna bridge your hips up towards the ceiling. And your choice, if you have a block, you can slide your block underneath your tailbone for supportive bridge. If you wanna interlace your fingers and pull your knuckles towards your heels and open up your chest, you can. Make sure that you're not arching your spine. So think of tucking your tailbone under and creating one long line from your shoulders all the way to your knees. One more inhale. And then exhale, you can slowly roll down. Maybe windshield wiper your knees from side to side, bring a little release. Good. And then we're gonna come into wheel pose. So again, even if you know how to get into wheel pose, just take these steps with me. So knees are bent, feet are flat on your mat. Bring your hands by your ears. Keep your head where it is and press your hips up like you're in bridge pose. Squeeze your arms towards one another and then lift just the top of your head to the mat. Push your arms down so that you're in your full wheel pose. And you can stay there for a few breaths if you get into it and you feel you need to like abort, abort, abort. That's totally fine. You can come down and come into bridge pose. Good, nice. See how much you can push into your arms. Open up your chest. Good. We'll stay here for two more breaths. If you're ready to come down now or whenever you're ready, you can come down. Good. And then when you're ready, after your second breath, you can roll down, windshield wiper your knees from side to side. And then we'll just do a quick supine twist and then we'll end, we'll do our shavasana in legs up the wall. So, yogi's choice. You can bring both knees in towards the chest and stack both knees to the side. If you want to do regular supine twist, just one knee in. If you want to do an eagle wrap for your supine twist or a figure four twist, I'll tell you when to switch sides. And the whole world is on your case. I could offer you a warm embrace to make you feel my love. Good. A seated twist also works if you want to do a seated twist. When the evening shadows and the stars appear. And then when you're ready, up and over to the other side. Dry your tears. I could hold you for a million years to make you feel my love. Go to the ends of the earth for you. A few more breaths here. Try and sink into your mat. Release your shoulders and your neck. Sorry, bad time for my dogs to bark. And then when you're ready, slowly bring your legs back. And you can hug your knees in towards your chest. If you want to rock from side to side, you can. Or maybe make some circles in your knees, you can. And then you're going to make your way again. We're going to do Shavasana with legs up the wall. So if you have a block and you want to slide your block underneath your hips, if you have a wall close by and you want to, or something close by that you'd like to support your legs on, you can wiggle and roll yourself over to your wall or whatever that is. And if it doesn't feel supportive for you to go legs up the wall, then you can definitely do traditional child's pose or rest however you need to. Take a moment to get there. The winds of change are blowing wild and free. Take a big inhale through your nose. And exhale through your mouth. Another inhale through your nose. Exhale through your mouth. One more inhale through your nose. And exhale through your mouth. And take a moment to scan your body. Notice how your body feels without judgment. No need to change or shift your body. Just notice. Notice how your breath feels. Notice what part of your body moves as you breathe. And just allow your breath to be natural. You can take your focus off of your breath. You can take your focus off of your body. Just take a moment to pause and find stillness. And you might notice your mind wanders off the present moment, and that's okay. As soon as you notice your mind has wandered, let go of your thoughts and pull your mind back to center. Back to the present moment. Maybe it wanders off once or twice. Maybe it wanders off 100 times. That's okay. Pause here for another moment and I'll tell you when it's time to come out. Thank you.
Take a big inhale through your nose. Exhale through your mouth. Take another inhale through your nose. Exhale through your mouth. One more inhale. And exhale. And start to feel some movement and start to bring some movement into your hands and your feet. If you want to wiggle and move your jaw around, you can. And take your time. When you're ready, just roll off to the side. Pause for a moment on your side. And then you can push your weight into your hands and slowly push yourself up to a seated position. Doesn't matter which way you face. Palms touch, thumbs rest on your breastbone. Close your eyes or keep your gaze soft. Take a moment to thank yourself for making it to your mat. Thank yourself for making the choice to work on your mind, body, and spirit. Bring your thumbs to your third eye, the pocket of energy found right in between your eyebrows. Bow forward. I thank you for showing up and allowing me to guide you through this practice. The light in me sees and honors the light in you. Namaste. Namaste, yogi.